It's an honor. Thank you, CNN, IBN. Unlike Ms. Saina, I can't say I richly deserve this. It's a long queue, and I think I've jumped the queue. I'm truly honored. It gives me strength to go forward and do something better than what all I've done. Thank you very much, sir.
Udta, Punjab film controversy. What we are now understanding is that this movie, which was given this name Udta Punjab by the filmmakers Anurag Kashyap and Abhishek Chaubey, may actually not be Punjab anymore. As per the censor board, the film cannot be using the word Punjab except in its title, creating a big trouble now for the film. What's now going to happen is that the filmmakers have been told, if you do not remove that word Punjab and if you do not agree to those 40 cuts which have been asked for, the movie may not get a release certificate. The committee says Udta Punjab cannot refer to the word Punjab, nor can it refer to any cities in the state. The revising committee of the censor board has asked for 89 cuts in the film. Not just that, 35 instances of cuss words are also on the chopping board. The film tribunal's ruling comes after the Akali Dal raised objections to the film. The film, which stars Shahid Kapoor as a Punjabi rock star Tommy Singh, is based on the widespread use of drugs in the state. The matter is now set to be taken up by the film tribunal sometime post the 20th of this month. Now, frankly, this entire controversy raises some very, very pertinent questions. So these are the five questions which I'm raising on the basis of these censor board moves. Is the censor board really behaving like cultural thekedars? Is that what Pala Jilani has been reduced to? Is there a clear-cut political motive behind this move which has been indulged in by the censor board chief? What exactly is Mr. Nilani's game? Who gains by censoring films? In the age of internet, does this kind of hyper-censorship, which is being indulged in by the censor board, does it really work? And fifth and final question, is this nothing else but a mere attempt to pressurize filmmakers to stay away from politically contentious subjects? And all these five questions lead to one basic question, which I am now going to put to my guest, Mukesh Bhatt, on the program tonight, who's our first guest on Big 5 at 10. Is the censor board going overboard? Is that what's happening with Udta Punjab controversy? Joining me tonight, Mukesh Bhatt, well-known filmmaker and someone who has also had his own experiences with the censor board. Thanks for joining us on Big 5, Mr. Bhatt. Let me just ask you, what do you make out, sir, of this scissor-based approach, Kanchi Chalana, on New Age cinema? Do you agree with this approach?
Dekhi, ye jo baat ho rahi hai regarding Udta Punjab, मिस्टर निलानी एक फेस है, एक चेहरा है जो प्रोजेक्ट किया गया है विद द मिनिस्ट्री इन पार. आई डोंट थिंक सो ये उनके पक्ष में इतनी ये है कि वो ऐसे रिडिकुलस चीजें कट्स रिकमेंड कर सकते हैं कोई भी फिल्म मेकर को. वो भी फिल्म मेकर रह चुके हैं कि आप एक टाइटल है उड़ता पंजाब और आप कह दें कि पंजाब को उड़ा दो टाइटल, यू कट द वर्ड पंजाब,
राइट? So what are you suggesting then, sir? Are you saying that what's actually happening is that there's politics in the censorship of this movie? Are netas dictating Mr. Palaj Nilani?
मुझे एक बात बताइए कि पंजाब कोई वर्ड शब्द जो कोई एक स्टेट का नाम है, कोई गाली तो नहीं है जो उनको ऑब्जेक्शन हो सके कि क्यों गाली है या कुछ वल्गैरिटी है या कुछ वायलेंट बात कर रहे हैं. पंजाब एक स्टेट का नाम है और अगर उसको मेंशन करने से कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो रही है तो डेफिनेटली वो सीबीएफसी की प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, वो प्रेशर कोई और जगह से आ रहा है जो आप अच्छे तरह से जानते हो और मैं अच्छे तरह से जानता हूं.
तो सर, डज दिस मीन मुकेश साहब दैट द सेंसर बोर्ड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे हैज सिंपली बिकम अ पॉलिटिकल टूल? इज मिस्टर पलार निलानी टुडे अ पॉलिटिकल एजेंट?
वो हमेशा था, वो आज नहीं, पहले से था. पहले से अगर जब यूपीए गवर्नमेंट थी उस टाइम भी डिक्टेट होता था. जब तक आप सीबीएफसी को एक इंडिपेंडेंट बॉडी नहीं बनाए और पॉलिटिकल अपॉइंटमेंट्स नहीं होगी, ये होता रहेगा. मैं 40 साल से इस लाइन में हूं, मैंने बार बार ये प्रॉब्लम को फेस किया है कि जब कोई भी गवर्नमेंट पार में आती है वो अपने एजेंडा के साथ आती है और अपने प्रेशर लगाती है अपने लोगों पर जो वो अपॉइंट करते हैं. तो अभी वक्त आ गया है कि अभी हम इस चीज को ये जो पुरानी चीजों को बंद करें, एक ट्रांसपेरेंसी लाए, एक ऑटोनोमी लाए, ताकि इसमें कुछ एक प्रैक्टिकल अप्रोच होना चाहिए. क्योंकि अभी हम आज फिल्म बनाते हैं, करोड़ों रुपया लगाते हैं, हमें पता नहीं है कि कल किस तरफ हवा जाएगी.
राइट. लेकिन बट साहब एक बात नहीं समझ में आ रही मुझे. एक और आप ये कह रहे हैं सर कि ये कोई नई चीज नहीं है कि पॉलिटिकल बॉसेस जो है वो सेंसर बोर्ड को डिक्टेट कर रहे हैं. लेकिन फिर मुझे आप ये बताइए कि हमने पिछले करीबन एक डेढ़ साल में कुछ ऐसी भी फिल्में देखी हैं जो रिलीज हुई हैं जो कि कही जाती हैं कि वो अडल्ट फिल्म्स हैं, लेकिन वो अडल्ट फिल्म से भी कहीं ऊपर जाके हैं. उसको लेकर भी बड़ा विवाद खड़ा हुआ. पीपल थॉट दैट वाज अ सॉफ्ट पोर्न व्हिच वाज बीइंग सोल्ड लाइक अडल्ट फिल्म्स. इफ यू कैन गिव क्लियरेंस टू दोज फिल्म्स, देन व्हाई कांट यू गिव क्लियरेंस टू दीज फिल्म्स व्हिच आर पॉलिटिकली कंटेंशियस इन नेचर.
मैं देखो अगर सनी लियोन की पिक्चर वो पास करते हैं तो वो एडल्ट पिक्चर होती है कि नहीं? वो बच्चों के लिए तो नहीं होती है. तो मैं आज 60 साल का एक सीनियर सिटीजन हूं, मुझे अगर एक एडल्ट फिल्म देखनी है तो मेरे को एक हक है एडल्ट फिल्म देखने का कि नहीं? कि मुझे आप एक 9 साल के बच्चे की तरह ट्रीट करोगे? जब एक लड़का 18 साल का हो जाता है तो आपके गवर्नमेंट के हिसाब से वो बेचौर हो जाता है, इतना बैलेंस हो जाता है, इतना समझने लगता है कि वो वोट बराबर दे सकता है कि कौन सी गवर्नमेंट के कौन से गवर्नमेंट को पार में लाना है. वहां उसको मेच्योरिटी 18 साल की उम्र में आ जाती है, मगर 60 साल की उम्र में उसको पिक्चर देखने की मेच्योरिटी नहीं आती.
ठीक है,
ये कोई लॉजिक है इसमें?
अग्रीड. आई एग्री विद यू. यू हैव अ पॉइंट व्हिच इज व्हाट आई एम रेजिंग सर, व्हिच इज व्हाट आई एम रेजिंग दैट व्हाई शुड सेंसर बोर्ड बी एक्टिंग लाइक दिस काइंड ऑफ अ कल्चरल ठेकेदार. बट थैंक्स सो मच मुकेश भट्ट फॉर जॉइनिंग अस राइट एट द टॉप ऑफ बिग 5 एट 10. बट दैट पॉइंट व्हिच वाज मेड बाय मुकेश भट्ट अबाउट पॉलिटिशियंस डिक्टेटिंग सेंसर बोर्ड, लेट्स टेक दैट पॉइंट फॉरवर्ड. लेट्स ब्रिंग इन पॉलिटिशियंस नाउ. लेट्स रेज द सेकंड की क्वेश्चन ऑन द प्रोग्राम. इज दिस अबाउट सेंसरशिप or is this about politics ahead of Punjab elections? So are we literally seeing a political battle brewing in the garb of this censorship battle? Joining me to answer that question, Dr. Pramod Kumar. He's the director of the IDC. He's joining us from Chandigarh, and questions from the Congress side, Tom Vodakkan. Pramodji, what is this about? Is this about some kind of an insecurity which the Akali Dal has in Punjab? Is that all that there is to this story?
Bhupinder ji, the only thing I would like to say is that the drug problem in Punjab is secular and it is above party affiliations. And why I am saying that, during the last 3 decades, political parties have used drugs to get votes.
Right.
And now they are making noises against the drug abuse to get votes. For them, drug abuse or drug opposition to drug, both I mean, are a currency in politics. So for me, it's not a question of Congress party or Akali Dal or anyone. The political parties are using such problems to get currency, to get more votes.
Okay.
And number two, I mean, the point which I thought should be made here is that labeling and stigmatization issues. Well, if you label, I mean, states, people on various issues, for example, the truckers in Punjab were labeled as HIV AIDS affected. And therefore, what happened that their families were not getting, I mean, married, I mean, people were not coming forward to marry within them. So if it is a question of only labeling and stigmatization, it can be fought in social discourses rather than banning the films.
You know, talk
about taking out certain things.
Agreed.
For me, the main issue is labeling and stigmatization.
Labeling and stigmatization, that should be stopped. But Tom Vodakkan, it's quite interesting that Rahul Gandhi, a couple of years back, himself had taken this position that Punjab had become a hub of drug abuse, and then he was taken to the cleaners by various political opponents, including the Akali Dal. Where does the Congress party stand on this ban which is being imposed on this film by the censor board?
Well, as your question is a broad canvas, I would like to be very specific. You see, this whole issue has arisen. The censor board has said that there should be about 40 cuts.
Right.
Then there is that revising committee. The object of the revising committee is essentially to ensure there's no mistakes committed by the board. And the revising committee puts it to 89 cuts. For all practical purposes, that film stands totally cut it out of shape. And now, to top it all, there is a title. I've been on the appellate board and the censor board for 12 years. in the Censor Board for quite a long years and on the Appellate Board. I know it often happens that it is not political pressure, it is people, individuals who are stakeholders in the film who approach you saying, look, either pass the film or... Now, this kind of issues do come up. But when we get into the Censor Board meetings or review a film, we wear a very professional hat and look at it purely from the social point of view. And our job is to go by the Cinematographic Act.
So what are you suggesting? What are you suggesting, Tom? Are you saying, Tom, are you saying that Pehlaj Nilani has exceeded his brief? Has he exceeded his brief, or are you in agreement with the decision which has been taken?
I think he has not only exceeded his brief, but he is totally gone out of tune. He is a film producer. He should know that 40 cuts means destroying the film. Creativity is destroyed. I had a situation when Rajneeti was coming up. I faced personal criticism by the current information broadcasting minister, who wrote half a page by line criticizing me, where I had not touched the film with even a barge pole. And there I was criticized. But we look at every film purely creative point of view, and as to the question of grading it, it is not our job. We are not moral policing or censoring anything.
But
now the whole question of dragging it into Punjab elections,
right,
the timing may...
I mean, that's frankly the real question.
The timing is an issue.
The timing, you know, but there is the other point as well, Pramodji, which can be raised at this stage, and that is Punjab's association with cultural controversies. Yeah. And I'm just looking at so many instances. You know, there was this other movie, Kaum De Heere, which was based on life of Beyant Singh. That also ran into trouble. Big Boss 7 contestant Ellie Avram, when her posters were put up in some colleges of Punjab, that went into trouble. We all have seen what has happened with Gurmeet Singh, you know, the Dera Sacha Sauda Chief. What is this about Punjab, sir? Is Punjab becoming some... Is there some kind of an identity question which is at play here, which is being reflected constantly through these various bans which are being imposed?
I think, I mean, Bhupinder, we can place it in the All India contest. I mean, if you say that most of, I mean, such intolerant, the fringe groups, I mean, raise such kind of questions. And if they raise these questions, the society should be developed enough to ignore it.
Okay.
But somehow, our political class comes to those questions raised by the fringe groups.
Okay.
And then resort to such kind of bans, which I find not very democratic, not very liberal. So somehow, in Punjab, it's not Punjabi society.
So you are an
tolerant
advisor. No,
it
I just want to know, sir, you are also an advisor to the Akali government, Pramodji. You are an advisor to the Akali government. You are saying, therefore, that this ban is wrong? You are saying this ban should not be in place?
No, I'm number one, I'm not advisor. I'm basically, I mean, only a part of some committee which is looking into these governance issues. I find this ban is totally wrong.
Totally wrong.
And this ban should not be done because it is undemocratic. It's not, I mean, conformed to the liberal values.
Okay.
Such things should be debated in public forums. And we should sensitize people if there is something wrong in the film rather than banning it.
All
absolutely
right.
wrong.
Absolutely wrong. Tom Vadakkan and Pramod Kumar, thanks for joining us on Big 5 at 10.